another joke.
What did the buffalo say to his son when he was leaving for college?
Bye, son.
Yes. What do you call a cow with no legs?
Rabbit.
Yep.
Rabbit. My cow sounds out of the way.
And you just like sing in that his CDs down in the lobby. There's these two Joy's performance tonight. And there's a painting for a silent auction of this poster right here. That also downstairs in the lobby. So if you'd like to stand, yeah.
Well, things ready.
You guys are for a good job. PD Pedersen.
You say it right the first time.
Bill just helped me with some tape to fix this flute. I don't know enough yoga to play. It's really long. This is a shruti box I'm playing with my feet. It's from India. It just has this nice drumming thing. And what I do when it stops, I'll demonstrate. What I do is multiphonic singing. It's culturally, it's from Tuva, Asia, Tibet, kind of the middle of Asia, where people are doing it for different shamanic and gaming practices. And then Inuit women do it singing for, gaming and healing and what's the thing when you're pregnant? The art of being a mother. And so a demonstration of what it sounds like is
I'm not
I was one of those kids who was babysat by the TV. Don't make that mistake. But I grew up imitating everything because it was just my way of communicating with the world, which is strange to me as a child. I think it was a strange kid. But I grew up to be all the shows that I wanted. My favorite shows were Kung Fu, hence the flute, Emergency, Johnny and Roy, the paramedics, and the Galloping Gourmet. I'm a chef. I'm out of in retirement right now. I'm a freelancer. And I've been to Alaska. I've been coming to Alaska since 86. I came here for my 23rd birthday. To stay with my sis. She's up there somewhere. She's great. And the midnight really inspired me. The fact that there was very little day. I've been up here. This is my seventh trip to Alaska and my third at the Anchorage Folk Festival. Thank you so much. It's been such love. I appreciate the night. And I just have so much gratitude. In the last 20 years, I moved from California to Wisconsin, herded sheep. You'll hear sheep and dogs and pigs and all sorts of things in my performance. And then I learned to throat sing, which was from having a didgeridoo for years that I used to play. A didgeridoo is a hollowed out piece of a tree that goes. When you go inside of it, perfect instrument for me. But my paramedic skills taught me the muscles and anatomy and physiology of what's going on here. So when my voice broke one day, it hurt, but I was like, that's interesting. And it sounds really cool, and now I've developed it into. Last year, I got to go to Hollywood to see a friend's play. And he was in the middle of the Hollywood Fringe Festival, which is 300 plays in 2 weeks in Hollywood. And I saw 6 plays in 24 hours. And I got on a bus to go back to San Francisco, and I said, I'm going to write a play. So it's about a little boy who should be in front of a microphone in Hollywood. He knows it from the age of 5, but it takes him 50 years to get there. Here this week. All my performances in Anchorage are behind me. I did my second show at my second birthday show at Modern Dwellers yesterday. It's a lovely little setting where I get to go and do my thing. I've done a few adult gigs at Van's Dive Bar. We've been having the greatest time. Oh, and I got to do a course, a demo, a presentation last week, extended voice and throat singing introduction, in which I didn't encourage people to make so many noises that they didn't talk about what I do. And they're like, we're okay with that. That seems scary. So the red light's on. Thank you so much. And I'm going to be out of here in a couple seconds. I'm just going to end on this note. Well, this five note. Carol Burnett would say, I'm so glad we had this time together. No, wait, that's Popeye. Just to have the last words sing a song. Seems we just get started, and before you know it, comes the time we have to say, so long. How we. So long. Thanks.